Good day, Blue Jays. I am the Sports Jim, coming to you with all the scores, all the time from the last week's action from all sports teams. I am the Sports Jim, coming to you from Studio 3B at CP. That's the basement. Let's get at it. Wrestling activity last week. The North Invitational last Friday, won by Millard North, but finished somewhere in the middle of the pack with about 20 teams competing. Impressive performances by the following Blue Jay wrestlers. Zach, the Boa, Constrictor, Dominguez, finishing first, the champion in the 152-pound division. This guy, Dominguez, Boa, he's a Boa Constrictor, he's an animal, he ought to be on Wild Kingdom, this guy. Defeated the state runner-up from last year in a very tough match. Sophomore Tim Andrews, placing fifth, Brush, Eli, Spanky, Dominguez, also placing fifth. Joe Martinick, sixth place in the heavyweight. Pat Nastasi, sixth place in the 130. There will be a dual wrestling meet this Tuesday at 6 p.m. Now, for all you people at Papio, dual, that means two teams are competing. 6 p.m., but Creighton Prep, Peter. All right, swimming. The Blue Jays, defending state champions, hit the pond this coming Tuesday night against Burke in a dual meet. Whoa, Papio, that's two teams, okay? Be there, Blue Jays. Cheer on the defending state champions. Captains, seniors Jeff Brewery and Matt Frogman Ennenbach, the men to watch, as well as Jim Hood, Brian Porter, and Pat Kelsey. Watch for them. And now, on the parquet, basketball activity last week. The Blue Jay varsity split last Friday and Saturday night. Friday night's 1 point at the buzzer loss to Bryant was then Saturday, when Junior Jay snatched an overtime victory with a Matt McMahon layup with 3 seconds to go on the clock right above Matt. JV also splitting, losing to Bryant and defeating Millard West. Brian Smarter and Andy Hayes played extremely well, however. Sophomore team posted a victory over South 52-48. Tim Christensen with 14 points. TJ Fife with 10. The freshman A and B team both splitting last week, both losing to West Side, both defeating North. Check out this score against Westside, 23-19. They're playing football out there, the freshman B team. Good defense. Basketball. All teams are active this week. Consult your schedules. And now, gentlemen, we have for you two Alleluia Awards to be given this week for outstanding play last week. They go to Zach Boa, Dominguez, and Nick Svila for scoring 27 points in his first two varsity games. As a sophomore, way to go. Let's give you those hallelujahs, boys. This is the Sports Jim saying, I am out of here. Support your Blue Jay teams. Have a great week. Coming to you from Studio 3C at CP. That's the ballroom, fellas. All the sports, all the time, because I am the Sports Jim reporting to you on CP TV. Now let's get into it. Bowling action from last week. The Jays rolled to a 12-8 victory last week over Bellevue West. They faced Benson at Leisure Lanes Monday night. The Jays are led by Adam Heim and Chad Goodwin, the Big Rollers. No pun intended. Go get them, boys. Swimming in the pond, the defending state champions crushed all opposition in the Blake Invitational last Saturday afternoon. It looked like the Battle of Midway out there. The Jays racked up 442 team points. Papio, second place, 185 points. Everybody else, get to the back of the line. We are the champions. Yes, cup medalists, I've too numerous to name not so many guys we have finished in first, second, or third place. Actually, we did that for every single swimming event except for one. Cup relay team finished also first in the 200, 400, and 200 medley relays. We were outstanding! The next meet is Tuesday at WS 4 p.m. Could this be the greatest swimming team of all time? I don't know. Stand by. Wrestling. Blue Jay Varsity fared very, very well in the South Invitational last Friday of South High School. Cup finished fourth place. Of our medalists, that is those finishing in the top five, were the following. Eli Spanky Dominguez finishing in the 103-pound class division. Not first, but did very well. Tim Andrews, second place. Alvin Wilcox, fifth. Pat Mastasi, fifth place. The big match of the meet. Plus Zach Vaboa Dominguez taking first place. The champion in the 152-pound division. Adam Downs, fourth place. Mike Sandin, fourth place. Let's pick up the action with Zach Vaboa Dominguez against Mike Sheck of Bellevue East. Yes, Dominguez defeated the state runner-up from last year in a very, very tough, tough match. Johnny! What do you think, Johnny? Zach Vaboa Dominguez. This guy's an animal! He ought to be on Wild Kingdom. He's a boa constrictor! Outstanding effort. Varsity Wrestling meet this Tuesday at Burke against Burke and Millard West. 6 p.m. Be here. Round one on the parquet. Basketball for those of you who don't understand sports lingo. The sophomore team was host last week against Papillion by 1 point, but played extremely well. They have 3 games this week. Consult your schedule. Varsity Basketball swept a 2-game weekend series over Bellevue West on Friday and Westside at home on Saturday. Yes, that was the Westside story. The World Herald said it all. Check it out. Crunch over Westside 72-67. Dan Webbin with a season high of 20 points. Johnny, roll the tape. Next stop, the holiday tournament at Civic Auditorium. Watch the newspaper for details that'll happen over the vacation. Be there. Now, while there were many fine performances last week in our sports, the Sports Jub wishes to give two very special awards, the Hallelujah Awards, for two interests of the week. One to the Blue Jay Swims team for crushing everybody last week, and another to the Blue Jay student body. That's you boys, because you guys showed a lot of class. Here, in the Birdcage, Saturday night at our gym, when Westside student body held some, shall we say, rather classless choice of cheers, you didn't respond. When you don't slump to that level, Blue Jays, it makes us all look great. You got a lot of class. Keep up the good work, boys. And now, the Hallelujah Award coming at you. Legend voice, I'm the Sports Jub saying, you betcha, I'm out of here.
Chances are, cause I will serve you the moment you come into view. And all you think that I know.
Sports Gym coming to you from Studio 3C at CP. That's the Boiling Room, fellas, in the basement. Here to bring you all the sports from the last week. Without further ado, let's get at it. Varsity basketball against Northwest. Johnny, show us what you've got. Northwest, last Saturday, Northwest, no match for the Blue Jays, who came out ahead 76-49, the Blue Jays, out on top of that one, looking good. The Blue Jays, look, Dan Webben leading the scoring with 14 points, Mike Coma adding 11, looking pretty good. Last Saturday, last Friday's game, Kingston against Central, look, beat rescheduled. And here we are with one of the big men, underneath, Scott Munter, going up and in. Jays. That's a deuce. Here at the free throw line shooting. Louis Vigneault up and in. That's one.
Now, runner-up, 205, 200 points. UJ Swimmers, you do make us proud. We are number one behind you. Other results, sophomore basketball. Our prep sophomore basketball team won the prep invitation sophomore tournament. Last week, they defeated Ron Colley by 4, gross by 8. And they post a 6-1 record. Sophomore team after a good start with Colin Flanagan, Tim Christian, the leading scorers. Vince Kingston fouled out the first guy to foul out this season for the sophomore team. Whoa! Vince, what's the deal? Anyway, aggressive play. There we go. Also, the wrestling team, the prep invitation, prep posted a fifth place finish out of 11 teams at the tournament over Christmas vacation right in the birdcage up here. Joey Muse finished third in that tournament. Mike Sandine, a third place finish. Tim Andrews with a fourth. Zach the Boa Dominguez taking first place in his weight division and being chosen the outstanding wrestler for the meet for the fourth straight year in a row. Way to go, Blue Jays. A fine showing for one and all. That's all for me, the sports jet saying, that's right, you betcha, I'm outta here. How you doing, boys? I am the Sports Jeb, and we got some action for you, sports. Last week, Creighton Prep, let's have at it. Outstanding performance by the swim team at Creighton Prep, maybe the best in history, as they went down to Kansas City to participate in the Kansas City Invitational last Saturday. 22 schools from Missouri, Iowa, Kansas, and Nebraska. 22 teams. Who do you think finished number one? Who else? The Blue Jays. We are the champions. Outstanding performances by the following swimmers. Jim Hood, Bill Whitechulis, Rob Seaton, Jeff Grieve, Brian Porter. Our 200 medley relay, 200 free and 400 free teams. All placing high, first, second, toyed, whatever. Everybody else, get to the back of the line. JV basketball action. It was this guy, Brian Schmatterer, having a huge, huge game. The Blue Jays, JV defeating Burke in overtime by 3. Schmatterer, 22 big runs on the game. They also played Millard North last week, lost by 2. That is, however, their only second loss of the year. Schmatterer, huge, huge week. Huge! Sophomore basketball, having a big victory against Westside last week by 15. They play 2 home games this week. Consult your schedule. Freshman basketball did not play last week. Played the week before. However, A and B playing Ron Colley, defeating Ron Colley. Freshman A put down a tenacious Ron Colley A team. And prep B blew out Ron Colley B, 73-34. It was their second win over Ron Colley. 13 or 14 players scored. Like the line you see here. Joe, I'm going to the hoop. Bayless, who is the scoring leader with 12 points? Pat Rhoda had 11. Mike, Doctor, defense, Garland, what the defensive leader. Basketball action to tell you about. Varsity playing 2 games last week, defeating Millard North, but falling to Burke in a very exciting game. In the game against Millard North, Mike Coma and Dan Lemon were the leading scorers. It was exciting. Even if we came up slightly short, we will have our day again. 3 games this week, consult your schedules. Lots of round ball. Oh! Metro Wrestling. Metro Wrestling. It was a fine performance for the Dominguez brothers. Eli Spanky Dominguez finishing third in the Metro, but it was her, Zach Dominguez, winning his third straight Metro Championship. Let's pick up the action. What does the coach have to say about this swirling controversy?
For the record, it wasn't my technical.
The sophomore team, sophomore basketball action Friday, 86-54 victory over North. Tom Pryor with 13 points. Jeff Clark, a career high of 8 points as well. Saturday, prep sophomore defeating Bellevue West 53-47. Tim Christensen, 15 points. Mike Jansen, 6. 9-1 the sophomores.
How you doing, fellas? This is the Sports Gym coming to you.
Freshman basketball results on tap from the last week. Very successful. Freshman A versus Bryan, 68-21. Blowout! Could this be a preview of what the Huskers might do to Akron next fall? Donald Lincoln, whoa! Derek Thompson, 14 points. Devin Miller and Adam Kingston combining 12 points each in that A match against Lincoln Northeast prep freshman team, 63-61. They were overpowering. Not by much, but they got the job done. B team against Bryan, 81-22 last week, outrouncing by 59 points. Not so much a men for every score. That's the way it goes. The B team was led by Chris Diapers Doss with 10 points. Broadway Joe Bayless also scoring 10 points. And Pat Jehoda earning another 9 for freshman basketball. Last week, what a performance by the Varsity. A hat trick by the Junior Jays with victories over Bellevue West. Friday in the third game over North. 1 point at the buzzer and a victory Saturday night over Hastings. Rated number 1 in the state no more. The Blue Jays move up in the rankings to number 5 according to the World Herald. But this weekend, ladies and gentlemen, this is the man right here, Michael Coma, scoring the game-winning basket against North Friday night with a second left to put the ice on that victory and scoring 23 huge points against Hastings. Coma, a huge performance, earns him the Hallelujah Award. Ladies and gentlemen, Michael Coma, a man who needs no introduction, famous everywhere.
Hi, you guys, this is Michael Coma, and he plays basketball. Coma, my father, excuse me, and he plays basketball and basketball as well.
And finally, Blue Jay Wrestling, freshman, Ralston Invitational, prep freshman finished somewhere in the pack. Blue Jay coaches say that this is the best squad that they've had in 5 years, and the freshman's squad making great progress. Here we have Al Gigantor Stinson, who finished in fifth place. Pat Cantor with a fourth place finish. Dan Glasgow, third place finish also for his freshman team. Congratulations, Al Gigantor Stinson. A fine finish. The varsity wrestling action at the Burke Invitational last Saturday. The prep varsity wrestlers, an outstanding finish, finishing third place overall. An excellent showing for the varsity champions. Zach Dominguez with the fastest pin in the tournament. 11 seconds. He's an animal. Also, champion Adam Dodds. Congratulations. Third place finishes too. Tim Andrews, Eli Dominguez, Pat Nastasi, and Mike Sandin of the Blue Jays. And finally, a huge congratulations going out to Creighton Prep's Brothers for Others BFO. Successful dance 2 weeks ago in the gym. Everyone had a wonderful time. And everybody loves a prep spot. This is a sports gym, saying, that's right, don't be a thug. Okay, you betcha. Huh? I'm out of here. Game time. minutes late. We have last week, last Wednesday, this game against the number one Central Eagles at that time. A highly emotional game. The Blue Jays came up short, but it was a most gallant effort. Boys, this is the Sports Chef coming to you from Studio 3P at CP. That's the boiler room, fellas. Starting off this episode with a very special birthday greeting for a guy extremely important to the sports program here, Mr. Reggie Morris. Reggie, happy birthday! We got a surprise for you, Reggie. Stand by. Check it out.
Hi, Boo. It's me. Happy birthday. I just hope you're having a great day, and I'll be waiting for you and my macho man, Bubba.
Hey, Boo. Boo. Happy birthday, Boo. From all of us. We love you, big guy. On the bowling! The Blue Jays varsity and JV bowling competition at Kelly's Bowl. Monday. The results. JV over Bryant, 14-6. Varsity losing in a tight match to Millard South. The Metro bowling tournament will be next week. So, stand by. There you go! Picking it up for the Jays. Meanwhile, in the pond, in swimming competition with the Blue Jays in a very tough beat, the Millard South Invitational defeating everybody, including Lincoln East, who was thought to be the strongest competition for the Blue Jays this year. Well, Lincoln East gets to the back of the line, the Blue Jays finishing first in the pond. Meanwhile, basketball last week, check it out, Dan McMahon, the three-pointer. It was all Blue Jays against South at South last Friday. We looked unstoppable in a very tight competitive game. Dan Webber, number 44, shown here, having a big game. Having 15 points on the evening, Dan Acrobat Webber. Gentlemen, this man, Mr. Nick Savela, having also a huge night, huge night. Nick Savela coming off the bench in the last 2 minutes to score 11 points. 11 for the sophomore in the final 2 minutes. Nick Savela. Basketball action last week. The JV team going 2-0. A 10-point win over North through Northwest. And a 6-point win over South on Wednesday. Bill Hutch playing good in that contest. Sophomore basketball. Bob Bad Boy Grant's squad is now the softies. 12-0 on the year. Having an outstanding week. Defeating Northwest 53-46 and Millard South 44-35. A special feature story on freshman Mercer Gunner, world-class archer right here at Creighton Prep. Yes, archery is his game. A world ranking is what he has. Mercer practicing last Sunday, as he normally does on the weekends. We talked to Mercer. You are Mercer Gunnels. Mercer, tell us what you got here. What's with this thing?
Well, this here is a sight rock, which you need to just peep
literally to fill jar, and you look down here to this pin, that's how you aim.
Okay, this kind of looks like an expensive piece of equipment. This is not your average summer camp third grade bow. What are they made out of?
The riser's made out of cast aluminum, and the looms are made out of fiberglass.
How about how many pounds pressure are there on this particular bow?
50.
Is that standard?
For me, kinda. For them, little people, they usually shoot around 70 pounds.
What's the range on a bow like this?
Shoots from anywhere from 45 to 60.
And how accurate are you at it? What distance are you accurate?
50 yards, I can keep it on line about that big.
So you could probably, you know, from your locker, just pick off almost anybody in the hallway, is that correct?
Yeah, that's correct.
Okay, where's your ranked, is that correct?
Yeah.
World ranking, top 100?
Yeah, in the top 100, about, I don't know, 85th, somewhere in there.
Not too bad, are you?
Yes! Ranked 85th in the world, our very own, Creighton Prep, Mercer, the Merc! Got it! Last week, the International Bench Press Competition, Coach Mackey.
He won the heavyweight division of the NFL Bench Press Contest last week at 285 pounds. And right now, fellas, he's just going to demonstrate some proper lifting technique. He's going to do 2 1/4 in a rep about 3 times. So, go ahead, Sean.
Oh, sure!
Getting a lift off, Ron. And as you see him doing this, you'll see, fellas, that the butt has to be flat on the bench. And he'll come down and touch his chest. With good technique there, and bring it up. He's got one more.
Yeah!
Heavyweight champion in the Intermural Bench Press Contest, Sean Stacks.
That's it, Blue Jays. You betcha! I'm out of here!
Good day, Blue Jays. I am the sports chub. Let's talk about sports and other things. First of all, Science Bowl. The Blue Jays against Lincoln Southeast. Our Science Bowl contestants finishing first. Prep 1 taking first place. Lincoln High School taking second. Our boys win a trip to the Science Bowl in Washington, D.C. Congratulations to Andy Bay, David Doty, Joe Johns, Brett Kaisershot, and Mike Lensba. Only the best. Way to go, Science Department. And on to other sports. The swimming action, the Metro Swim Tournament last weekend. The Blue Jays, they said they would do it, and they did. The Blue Jays sweeping the field, scoring 308 points to win the boys' title. In the Metro, with a total just 1 point less than the combined scores of second place North South and third place North North. Not only did the Blue Jays sweep the meet, but there were also 12 total academic athletic awards given out in the entire Metro and Prep boys. On, the swim team walked away with 5 of the 12 academic athletic awards. You make us proud. In wrestling action, districts, last week up in Sioux City, the Prep Blue Jays here practicing in anticipation of that meet. 8 wrestlers from the Blue Jay squad will appear at state this Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Champions Zach and Eli Dominguez finishing in first place. Others finishing second, third, and fourth are Gary Muse, Chris P. Gillen, Adam Donalds, Thomas Bossy, Tim Andrews, and Mike Sandy of Lincoln State. Blue Jays, consult your schedules, state, this weekend. Freshman 18 basketball action, Bob Deuce up and in. The Freshman A successful last week against Millard North. Victories for A and B squad.
Good afternoon, this is Coach Swanson here at the Birdcage, getting ready for the Creighton Prep Blue Jays versus the Forest Cougars. We're thinking that the A team is definitely ready to play, and the B team is primed and ready.
And the B squad team ready to play. How right you are, Coach. The B team, 52-50-50, victory over Gross in the Birdcage on Thursday, and spanking for 64-34 on Friday. Meanwhile, the sophomores having a heart attack of a game against Millard North last Saturday in the Birdcage. DJ Fight scoring 11 in that contest. This man, Matt Garland, with 13. It looked like a rugby contest. In the end, it was a Hail Mary at the buzzer that dropped the softies. Sad but true, but our team is still 12-2. The softies are fine here. JV action over Rockford, 79-59. Rudersdorf in. Rudersdorf finishing with 16. Matter of 21. Vincentini 8. That was the Varsity Jays winning Friday and Saturday. Louis Vigneault, a big bucket, and that's how the weekend was, as the Jays defeated Papio and Rockhurst on Saturday night, a sweep. And just in case you missed our halftime shot, our winner from Kansas City. And one more time in slow-mo, just in case you missed it. Backboard or not, you'll be the judge. Blue Jays, this is the Sports Job. It's been a big week, and we've got some big stories, starting with wrestling, state meet, Lincoln last weekend, Johnny Rowland. Academic Decathlon, the Blue Jays were right up there as always, finishing third place overall behind Burke and North. A stellar performance by our guys. Top scorer for the prep team was Jay Capilano, and the student earning the most individual awards was Jerry Sanders, along with a host of other prepsters. Be sure and see the hardware these guys earned in the display case on the first floor. Hey, let's talk about swimming in the pond. We have the Wilson Last Chance Meet February 20th. The following Blue Jays qualified for state, along with the others already going. Kyle McCulley in the 53. Freshman Matt Burns in the 103. Matt Chelsea, Pat Longo. Freshman, junior John Millay, senior Matt Carlson. Also going to state
Of the 24 guys on the prep Blue Jay swim team, 18 of them are going to state this weekend, Lincoln!
In chess action. Blue Jay Chess Club, finishing second place in the state tournament. On the right here, pictured, Shakur Saxena, finishing third place overall in the state tournament. Dave Vosburg finishing first place in the unrated players division in that same tournament. Freshman A basketball, the deuce! Yes, the season is over, and what a record it was, 18-5 record for the A-team. We could play for the Blue Jay A squad on the freshman team a fine week. Monday, defeating St. Albert, Tuesday, defeating Central, and Wednesday, defeating Northwest. Eric Thompson on the freshman A squad having a huge week last week, Tuesday and Wednesday alone, scoring 54 points last Tuesday and Wednesday. In B squad action last week, the freshman B finishing their season 12-5 overall. Freshman B team winning their last four games. Here, Petra Hoda on the big skybook. Meanwhile, sophomore team Coach Grant retires his team with a final record of 13-2, defeating Central last week. A fine season. JV squad, done for the season, 14-5. It was a great year. No video available on JV or sophomore squads. Our apologies, but a fine year. Meanwhile, varsity action against Millard South last Friday night saw a seesaw of a contest. Tyree Bolton here. First quarter looking good for the Blue Jays, hanging in their top against the scrappy Millard South. And then in the second quarter, they couldn't miss and we couldn't hit. By halftime, it was looking pretty ugly for the Blue Jays. But the Blue Jays never say die, and they came out in the second half ready for action. Ready for vengeance! And they got it. One more time, the shot heard round the gym. Whoa! There it is. Nick Cervella on the stuff. Man coming through with two critical free throws in the final 15 seconds of play to ice it for the Jays. And finally, Blue Jay volleyball started last week with the Blue Jays at Central. Number 4, Andy Bayer. Andy the Hammer Bayer. The Blue Jays winning the Central Invitational last weekend at Central. Next game Tuesday. You bet your Blue Jays, I'm out of here.